Welcome back to stage 3 of this demo series. In this stage, you're going to be creating the Cognito identity pool. And it's the function of this identity pool to take the Google authentication token that you received at the end of the previous stage, and then exchange this using an IAM role for temporary AWS credentials. So once this exchange has taken place, these temporary credentials will be provided back to our web application. And it's using these credentials that we're then going to be able to interact with the AWS resources. So Cognito identity pools need to be configured with one or more authentication providers, and once configured, it will exchange successful authentications with these providers for AWS credentials. And as I mentioned a second ago, this is done by assuming an IAM role, and that's what you're going to configure in this stage of the demo series. So to do that, we need to go ahead and move across to our AWS console. Okay, so we're back at the AWS console, and now we need to configure Cognito so it can be used to exchange the Google Auth token into valid AWS credentials. So let's go ahead and move to the Cognito console. So type Cognito into the Find Services box, and then open that in a new tab. Go ahead and move to that new tab, and then depending on whether you've used Cognito before, what you see might look slightly different. What we need to do is to move to the menu on the left, and we need to click on Federated Identities. Now, if you haven't created any identity pools before, then it's going to jump immediately to a screen allowing you to create a new identity pool. If you have used this before, then you might see an option to create a new identity pool, but in either of those options, you're going to end up on a screen allowing you to create a new identity pool. So we're going to be creating a brand new pool, and we're going to be calling it Pet IDF ID Pool. So go ahead and enter that in the identity pool name. Now, identity pools can deal with both unauthenticated identities and authenticated identities. So an example of when you might use this is if you have a mobile application which needs to provide a certain level of access for customers who aren't signed in, maybe read-only access to a DynamoDB database table, then you can use unauthenticated identities. In our case, we only want to allow authenticated identities to access our application. What we're going to do is to scroll down and expand authentication providers. This is where we configure the integration with the Google identity provider. So to do that, click on the Google Plus tab, and it will prompt you for your Google client ID. And this is the value that you noted down in the previous stage of this demo series. So it should start with a random number, and then at the end it should have apps.googleusercontent.com. So this Google client ID is what's used to enable the communications between Cognito and the Google identity provider. So go ahead and enter that, and then click on Create Pool. Now, how this works is that when our application receives a Google authentication token, it provides this to Cognito. Cognito assumes a role, and based on this role assumption, generates temporary security credentials. Now, the role which is assumed is configured at this point. So if we expand View Details, we'll see it's creating two roles. We have a role if we're using authenticated users, and we have a role if we're using unauthenticated users. Now it's only the authenticated users that we care about, so we'll be focusing on this role. Now we'll be updating the configuration of the role later. At this point, just go ahead and click on Allow to create these roles. And if everything's worked as expected, you should be provided with an identity pool ID. It's this that's highlighted in red on my screen. So just copy down between the speech marks and note this down somewhere safe. Once you've noted that down, you can go ahead and click on Go to Dashboard. So our serverless application will be passing in a Google Auth token to Cognito. Cognito will be assuming a role and using that role's temporary credentials to access S3. So what we need to do next is update the permissions allocated to that role and make sure that it has sufficient access to the private S3 bucket. To do that, we're going to move to the IAM console, so click in the services box, type IAM, and then open that in a new tab. And once there, go ahead and click on roles. Scroll all the way down and you should see two Cognito roles. So they should be called Cognito underscore and then pet IDF ID pool. And you should have auth underscore role and unauth underscore role. And we need to look at the auth role. So select Cognito underscore pet IDF ID pool auth underscore role. Once you've located that, just go ahead and click on it. Then click on the trust relationships tab. This is what defines what can assume this role. So the trusted identity is cognito-identity.amazonaws.com. So it's Cognito which can assume this role. Now it also has some conditions which restrict what can assume this role, and the top condition is the one that we're focusing on, and this ensures that only this identity pool is able to assume this role. So this means that only requests which are coming into Cognito using this identity pool are able to assume this role, get temporary credentials, and use those to access AWS. And the only identities which are able to use this ID pool are the ones which are configured by our application to use the Google Identity Provider. So we're creating this chain of trust between our serverless application, the Google Identity Provider, and then Cognito via this ID pool. Now on the permissions tab, we currently have one inline policy, and this determines what permissions the temporary security credentials have when this role is assumed. Now we want to make sure that those temporary credentials are able to access our private patches S3 bucket. Now to do that, we're going to add another policy, and this was a policy created by the CloudFormation template at the start of this demo series. So click on Attach Policies. Into the Filter Policies box, go ahead and type private patches, and this should show the private patches permissions managed policy. And if we expand that, it's pretty simple. It just grants list bucket and get object permissions on the WEBIDF hyphen patches private bucket. And this is the private bucket that contains the sensitive pictures of patches, the Wondercat. So we're going to attach this policy to this role, and this will mean that our serverless application is able to access this bucket. So check the box next to this managed policy and click on Attach Policy. Now that's everything that you need to do in stage 3 of this demo series. So now we've created the Cognito identity pool, that's created two IAM roles, and we've adjusted one of those IAM roles to grant permissions on our private S3 bucket. So now we have all of the details required to configure our serverless application to utilize all of these different services. So the Google Identity Provider, Cognito, and S3. That's what we're going to be doing in the next stage of this demo series. But for now, you can go ahead and complete this video. And when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.